Welcome back to my channel. So in this video I am going to teach you a new chapter, that is moving charges and magnetism. Already we are knowing about the magnet, that a magnet means it will attract the iron pieces, and we have studied the types of magnet also, that is bar magnet, horseshoe magnet and the magnetic needle which we are using for direction purpose. So all these things about magnet which we are familiar and we have seen in our nature also, but in this video we are going to study a new concept, that is moving charges can create a magnetic field, and this concept has been discovered by the scientist Oersted in 1821. So before 1821 we are knowing only that magnet means it will attract iron pieces, only this concept we are knowing. But after 1821 when Oersted discovered that moving charges can also create a magnetic field, means whenever a current is flowing in a wire around that region, around that wire the magnetic field is generated. So when he was doing some experiment, for example, see here, this is a circuit. So in this circuit I amount of current is flowing. So here he has kept one magnetic needle, and this magnetic needle was showing some deflection. By that he got confused. Why he got confused means, here this magnetic needle, when it shows deflection means whenever any magnet is kept near that magnetic needle, only at that time it will shows the deflection. But here there was no magnet, but still it is showing the deflection. By that only he started to think, and he discovered that concept, that is magnetic field can be generated by the moving charges. So here when he stopped the flow of the current, so what he has observed means whenever the flow of current is stopped, this deflection is also stopped, means this magnetic needle was not showing any deflection when the current flowing is stopped. Means here in this circuit, if there is no current, then there is no deflection. And again one thing, if the direction of the current is changed, means this battery has been changed, means polarity has been changed. So when the direction of current is changed, this deflection also got reversed, means its polarity is also reversed. So by this one thing we come to know that this deflection is totally dependent on the direction of the flow of current. So this was the observation of the Oersted. And next what we have observed means, see here in this wire, if I amount of current will be flowing, and here we have kept one magnetic needle, and this magnetic needle has shown some deflection. Why it is showing deflection means, in this wire I amount of current is flowing, because of that current here in this surrounding region the magnetic field will be generated. Because of that magnetic field it is applying force on this magnetic needle and it is showing the deflection. So this is our first observation. And next one thing, second what we have observed means, again in this wire we have taken same wire, but we have changed the direction of the current. Here the direction of current has been reversed. So what we have observed means the deflection of the magnetic needle is also reversed. So by this we can come to know that this deflection is totally dependent on the direction of the current. So this is our second observation. Next, third what we have observed means, we have taken the wire, and again here in this wire also I amount of current will be flowing, but here instead of this magnetic needle, here we have taken the charge Q, and this charge is at rest. Here in this case what we have observed means, this charge is not showing any deflection, it is not showing any motion, means this magnetic field is not applying force on the rest charge. This is the one of the special property of the magnetic field, means magnetic field can apply force only on the moving charges, it cannot apply force on the rest charge. So this is our third observation. And next, fourth what we have observed means, here in this wire I amount of current is flowing, and next here we have placed the charge Q, and we have given some velocity to this charge, and that is V, means we have given V velocity to this charge, and this charge is moving in this direction. But because of this magnetic field, what it has done means, it has deflected, it is showing some deflection. Instead of going in the straight direction, it got deflected. By this deflection we come to know that this magnetic field cannot increase the velocity of the charge or it cannot decrease the velocity of the charge. It can only change the direction of the charge. So this is the special property of the magnetic field. In electric field, what we have studied, in electric field means here in any surrounding area, if electric field is present, it can apply force on both rest charge as well as the moving charge. But here this magnetic field is not affecting the rest charge, it can affect only on the moving charge, and it can change the direction. Only it can change direction, it cannot increase. Suppose here in this region, if electric field is there, means it has been increased its velocity, but here it is changing its direction, not the velocity. Here its initial velocity and final velocity will be same. Here in this case, only its direction has been changed. Means magnetic field can neither increase or decrease the velocity of the charge, it can only change the direction of the charge. So this is the special property of the magnetic field, which is different from the electric field. So next, another thing. Suppose if I am telling that in this wire, if I amount of current is flowing, so surrounding area, the magnetic field will be produced. So next question arises, how much amount of magnetic field is produced? And next, another thing, what is the intensity at some particular position? Means suppose, for example, here I want to tell you, here this is the point P. At this point P, what will be the intensity of the magnetic field? And if I change the position, here this is the point P and here this is the point Q. At this point P and at this point Q, whether the magnetic means intensity of magnetic field will be same or different, and how it is changing, means its intensity, how it is changing, all those things we want to know. So for that, what we will do, we will calculate the intensity of the magnetic field. So to calculate that intensity of magnetic field, what we will do in physics, to calculate what we can do, means we can use either laws, we can use either formulas, or else any device or any equipment, by that we can find out the intensity of the magnetic field. So here, to calculate this intensity of magnetic field, we will use the Biot-Savart law, because that law has been given by the name scientist Biot-Savart. So using that Biot-Savart law, we can calculate the intensity of magnetic field, and we can tell that whether the magnetic field is stronger, weaker, and we can tell magnitude, we can tell the direction, everything we are going to study in the Biot-Savart law. And this Biot-Savart law I will explain you in the next video. So stay tuned.